Mr. Tiruchi Siva, even though you are not the next speaker, I have to break that order because I want you to come here after you speak. So now we are allowing you. But your time is 5 minutes.
Thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir. Sir, I rise to support the bill on behalf of my party, DMK, which seeks to amend the Right of the Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009. To extend the deadline for the teachers to acquire the prescribed minimum qualification. Sir, a true democracy is one where education is universal. And based on that, the 2009 RT Act was enacted. Sir, the quality of a nation depends upon the quality of its citizens. The quality of the citizens, though not exclusively, but on crucial factors, depends upon the quality of education. Yeah. And the quality of education undoubtedly depends upon the quality of the teachers. So prescribing minimum qualification for the teachers alone is sufficient. That's the question. What is the standard or the quality of education which is imparted to our students today? So the recent reports say that 60% of the engineering graduates are unemployed. And more alarming report has been come from the ISRO that 26% of the passed out engineering graduates are only employable. And where does it start? It starts from the primary level, upper primary level, and it reaches up to the higher education level. Sir, we say that we have got too many education institutions. The universities have multiplied, more number of colleges, but the quality of education, as Raghuman Bhai pointed out, comparatively, we don't compare ourselves with the neighbors. So the number of educational institutions does not signify or qualify the education's quality. So it implies that the government has got more responsibility to improve the quality of education. Sir, some reports I would like to point out here. I think the minister would take into consideration, rather he might have been earlier aware of it. The India's educational card shows ample room for improvement. The World Economic Forum's Human Capital Index, which takes into account educational quality in addition to access, ranked India at 78 out of 122 countries. The latest United Nations Human Development Report put India's mean years of schooling at just over 4, and its literacy rate for those 15 and above at a low of 63%. Sir, further, as per the annual status of education report survey 2014, which is administered by the Indian NGO Pradhan, it was found that learning of mathematics is a serious and major source of concern. As per the All India figures for basic arithmetic in 2014, only 25.3% of class 3 students could do a basic two-digit subtraction. For class 5 students, the proportion of students who could do a basic two-digit subtraction was just minutely higher than 26.1%. Sir, up to class 3, they are not able to do two-digit subtraction, and up to 5, they can do only two-digit subtraction. What is even more worrying is that the percentage of class 2 students who cannot recognize numbers up to 9 increased over time from 11.3% in 2011 to 19.5% in 2014. Sir, these are not just statistics, sir. The government has to concentrate more on that. Why? What is the reasons for that? As my colleague Mr. Vijay Sai pointed out, there are 9 lakh teachers vacancy in the country. The teachers' ratio, students' ratio is disproportionate. Already in UP itself, the vacancy is about 1.75 lakh. In the whole of the country, the vacancy is 9 lakh. So many vacancies are lying, and those teachers who are already employed are still lacking the minimum qualification means, sir, we call ourselves a developing country, and soon we are going to call ourselves a developed country, but the quality of education is still in this level only because of the vacancy of teachers. What are the steps the government is taking to fill up the vacancies? We may again say, sir, as Mr. Derek pointed out, it should come to the states again as it was before the emergency, the education must come to the state's power. Now that it is in the concurrent list, we are not able to do anything on our own because sometimes we are dictated by the center. Sir, the Ministry of Human Resources Development commissioned 2 studies for the attendance assessment rate of students and teachers in 2006 and 7 and 2012 and 13 within a period of 5 years. As per the study, 15.2% of the teachers at primary schools were absent during 2012-13. The figure was worse for the upper primary schools with teacher absenteeism at 16.9% during 2012 and 13. Sir, in another, I would like to quote a judgment. One moment, sir. Very important. A judgment given by the Rajasthan High Court in May 2015, Syed Sagid Ali versus Director, Secondary Education and others, the court ordered that assigning additional non-teaching responsibility to teachers needs to be seriously considered. The board results of the school in question in the case showed sharp decline in its performance, with the result of the students in class 10 mathematics examination declining from 77.41 to 20.73 in 2012 and 13. So I would like to suggest, earlier I moved a private member also, that assigning non-academic duties to the teachers also declines the quality of education in our country, sir. So already we are running short of the teachers' numbers in the schools. The teacher-student ratio is not proportionate, and assigning them other duties like election duties or surveying and all other things will much more minimize the quality of education. So I would suggest the minister, apart from extending the time, as you said, the bill may say it is extended for 4 years, but the left-out years are only 2 because okay. The bill has been brought up for discussion very late. Only within the 2 years you can fill in with minimum qualification teachers, sir. But we need the adequate number of teachers to be filled in all the vacancies.
Okay.
And so also the quality of education has to be improved. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Now you